If you're thinking about an extended stay in Mexico or moving to Mexico as an expat, then it's a good idea to know your legal residency options.
Most expats considering living in Mexico beyond the 180 days allowed as a tourist typically seek one of two types of visas, temporary residency or permanent residency.
That's right. Until recently, tourists were guaranteed an automatic 180-day tourist card on arrival in Mexico. Unfortunately, that's no longer the case.
So let's review your options and explain why we've decided to apply for permanent residency. But first, let's roll the intro.
Hola amigos, 2Gay Expats here. I'm Andy.
And I'm Trey. If you are new to our channel, welcome and thanks for joining us. On this channel, we highlight our adventures around the world to inspire your travels, as well as to show you what places are really like if you are thinking about living, working, or retiring abroad.
If you haven't already, please click the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of our travel adventures.
In this video, we are discussing the pros and cons of residency versus remaining a tourist, including the costs associated with legally moving to Mexico. And definitely stick around to the end of this video if you want to hear about our experience at the Mexican consulate and if our permanent residency application gets approved. It's our plan B in a very uncertain world, and we feel very safe here in Mexico.
Speaking of plans, our initial plan when we decided to build a house here was to spend 180 days in Mexico. But like Trey said, a number of recent changes in our life and how the government processes travelers have led us down the residency path.
As you can see behind us, our little slice of paradise here in Tulum, Mexico is still under construction over a year and a half after we signed our purchase contract.
The good news is that we're maybe 6 to 8 weeks out from delivery at this point.
Fingers crossed.
In addition to construction delays, we were only granted 130 days versus the usual 180 days on our last entry into Mexico.
And we recently had some friends who have been living in Mexico throughout the pandemic only get 14 days on their last entry.
We also caution you not to overstay the number of days granted to you by immigration.
You can be stopped at any time by the authorities on an auto bus or simply walking to the beach to prove you're legally in Mexico. We recommend having a copy of your passport and FMM or your tourist card on your phone, just in case you're stopped and don't have it physically on you, which is the technical requirement.
The bottom line is we don't want the added stress of not knowing how many days we can expect on arrival.
Or any restrictions really on how long we can spend in Mexico to enjoy our new house. So we're gonna apply for permanent residency. I know you're thinking, why permanent and not temporary? What are the benefits of each? Well, we've created a helpful summary to highlight the benefits of each residency type as compared to remaining a tourist, and it'll make more sense why we've decided to go for permanent.
Looking at the first two benefits on the list, the option for a one-time application with one immigration fee payment is a very attractive option to us.
If you go down the temporary visa path, which may be your only option, and to be fair, maybe what we end up with, given it's at the consulate's discretion, it will definitely require more time and expense.
To show you exactly what we mean by that, let's check out the cost summary for temporary versus permanent residency, so you can see just how expensive temporary residency can be if you continue to remain in Mexico after the initial year. Looking at the table, you will note that the 2022 Mexican immigration fees are 4,739 pesos or $237 for a temporary residency card up to 1 year, compared to 5,776 pesos or $289 for a permanent residency card.
But as you make your way down the table into future years, the temporary fees increase to over 10,000 pesos or over 500 USD as you stay up to the maximum of 4 years as a temporary resident. And then you are eligible to apply for permanent residency and of course pay that fee as well as a change of status fee. And this is on top of any professional fees you may require for assistance. We've been quoted anywhere from 2,500 pesos, or around 125 USD, up to 425 USD for one-time assistance.
So it's definitely less expensive in the first year for a temporary residency card, but not in the long run.
Returning to our benefit summary, the third item, and perhaps the most important benefit to both temporary and permanent residents, is the option to legally remain in Mexico for the entire year versus just 180 days or sometimes less with a tourist card.
Both residency options also allow you to open a Mexican bank account, get a Mexican driver's license without giving up your foreign one, buy and register a car in your name, join the national healthcare plan, buy property, and claim a homeowner's exemption to pay no capital gain tax on the future sale of your Mexican property. As you can see, all of these benefits are not available with a tourist card, with the exception of owning property.
As a side note, we are purposely not covering bringing a foreign plated car or household goods into Mexico, as both can be a headache with very specific rules, and also any mistakes can be quite costly. You can definitely buy a car here in Mexico. We also have Amazon, Costco, and a great local department store called Liverpool, and all of them deliver.
All right, now let's talk about added benefits for permanent residents only. In addition to no expiration for your permanent residency card if you are an adult, permanent residents over 60 can enroll for an ANAPM discount card for seniors, which provides even more discounts between 10 to 50% on a wide range of goods and services all across the country, from museums to travel to everyday living expenses. Lastly, permission to work in Mexico is included, although I recall not for those seeking permanent residency as a retiree.
Basically, permanent residents have all the rights of Mexican citizens except to vote and hold property in the restricted zones, which we're going to talk about in an upcoming video. Also, after 5 years of legal residency, you may be eligible for Mexican citizenship.
If all that sounds awesome, then the next step is to research the requirements at one or more Mexican consulates in the US, and then make an appointment at the one that works best for you.
We just arrived in Orlando for our permanent residency appointments in a few days. It took us a few weeks to find availability using the required online system, and we both needed our own appointments, even though we're married and applying together.
So where are we headed?
We are headed over to Office Depot to pick up 1,900 pages of financial records and other documents supporting our permanent residency visa application. And then we're headed over to Walgreens to pick up our passport photo. We have tons of errands to do today in order to get organized so that we are overprepared for our residency appointment in a couple of days. And Andy has been working very hard getting all this organized for us. So super excited.
I do the organization, he gets the margaritas, and we both enjoy the process.
I'm definitely ready for that.
As far as temporary or permanent residency requirements, the reason we recommend reaching out to one or more Mexican consulates is that each consulate is empowered to make their own decisions regarding applications.
So for us who are not of retirement age collecting a pension or Social Security, we needed a consulate that was only concerned with the income or asset-based test in order to meet the economic solvency requirements for permanent residency. The Mexican consulate in Orlando was that consulate for us. They immediately responded to our initial request by email for the current requirements for permanent residency, and we'll pop those up on the screen for you now.
Here's the full list. But basically, we need to bring our passport, one passport photo, the completed visa application, $48 in cash for the processing fee, and 12 months of documents showing either $4,300 of income per month or $172,000 of savings. Again, this is for permanent residency.
For temporary residency, the economic solvency requirement is approximately $3,000 per month or $45,000 in savings.
Another benefit of temporary residency is that it's more attainable with a lower threshold for income and savings than permanent residency. And after 4 years, you'll become eligible for permanent residency.
It's worth noting the financial requirements have been increasing year over year as they are tied to the Mexican minimum wage, and each consulate calculates their numbers a little bit differently based on this. So we can't recommend enough that it's wise to open a dialogue with one or more of the consulates by email and then print out those emails and bring them to the consulate with you.
We found the Mexican consulate in Orlando super helpful and very responsive to our questions by email. We asked them if we should apply separately or together, and they said together.
We also asked whether we should include any information on our home purchase and if any documentation would help our application, and surprisingly, they said no. All right, it's the moment of truth. We are here at the Mexican consulate in Orlando. We are ready for our residency appointment. Hopefully we are overprepared, fingers crossed.
Yeah, we're really excited about it. We've been planning for this for the last few months since we made our appointment a few months ago.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Well, great news, guys. We just got our permanent residency visa and our passports.
Such a relief, such an exciting day. The process was super smooth. It was just like going to a DMV in the US. Everyone was super friendly. It was very well organized. So yeah, we're super excited. Now we have 180 days to go back into Mexico, which we're gonna go next week, so no problem there. And then once on arrival back in Mexico, we have 30 days to go to an INM office, which is the local immigration office, to complete step two of the process. So stay tuned for that video. That'll hopefully be coming in the next couple of weeks. And how are you feeling?
I feel like I need coffee now.
Or a margarita.
Let's go
to
have
celebrate.
A margarita.
Let's go enjoy the rest of our time in Orlando.
Let's go. And one more thing. Just as we were leaving our consulate appointment, the officer let us know that we have to actually go through the residence line to begin the Kanye process when we arrive into Mexico for the first time.
That's right. The Kanye process is the process that actually gets us our permanent residency card. So we're looking forward to having that hopefully in a week or two. So stay tuned for that in part two. Also, we were delighted to see on arrival at the consulate, we forgot to mention this, that there were safe space flags with rainbow colors. There was a banner inside the immigration office as well as on each of the windows saying safe space and welcome with the rainbow flag for LGBT. So that was amazing. We really, really enjoyed seeing that. We follow a guy named Andrew Henderson, who's also known as the Nomad Capitalist, and he always says, go where you're treated best. We absolutely love that. Well, that's it for part one in the process to obtain Mexican residency. We're back in Playa del Carmen now, waiting for our appointment to be confirmed at INM, so stay tuned for part two in our residency journey to obtain our permanent resident cards.
If you haven't already, smash that like button and subscribe to our channel.
For more of our adventures, check out our travel blog at togetexpats.com and follow us on your favorite socials at togetexpats.
Thanks so much for watching.
Hasta luego.